Welcome to my channel Gauran the Motivator. Today we are going to discuss on a very interesting topic, heating effect of electric current. Okay, so when electric current is passed through a circuit, okay, when electric current is passed through a high resistance wire like nichrome wire, the resistance wire becomes very hot and produces heat. This is called the heating effect of current. The heating effect of current is obtained by the transformation of electrical energy into heat energy. The role of resistance in electrical circuits, okay, is same to the role of friction in mechanics. We will now derive the relationship, a formula for heating effect of electric current. Moving on to the derivation, here we have written, when a current I flows through a resistance R, okay, let's take a wire. And this particular wire has some resistance. So, when a current I flows, the current is flowing in this wire for time t, and time taken is t. So, rate of flow of charge, electric current. Now, in this case, when an electric charge q, charge, so current is nothing but flow of, rate of flow of charge. So Q is nothing but charge, moves against a potential difference. So we have a potential difference here. Okay, potential difference is nothing but, we are giving the source a cell. So potential difference, the amount of work done in this particular circuit is given by work done is equals to number of charges that flow into potential difference. Okay. So here, this flow of charges, we have already studied that I is equals to Q by T. This is what we have studied. So if you want Q, we will get Q is equals to I into T. Right? So in place of Q, we can substitute I into T. Okay? So W, work done, is equals to I into T. Okay, and we, according to Ohm's law, we have studied that Ohm's law states V is equals to I into R. So V, in place of V, in place of Q, we have substituted I into T. In place of potential difference, we are substituting I into R. Okay, so this, now if we take the work done, we get it as I into I is I square R T. Okay, so work done is equals to I square R T. Now assuming that the work done is completely transformed into heat energy, okay, so we can take that the amount of heat energy released is equals to I square R T. So in this heating effect of electric current, when we take that complete work done is being transformed into heat, okay, so we take it as heat energy is equals to I square R T. And this formula itself, okay, is known as Joule's law of heating. Joule's law of heating effect. So what does this Joule's law of heating says? That is nothing but heater produced in a circuit or in any substance or in any electrical equipment is directly proportional to the square of current, okay, and heat produced in the circuit is directly proportional to the resistance, and directly proportional to the time. Okay, so this can be written as H is directly, heat is directly proportional to I square, square of current, heat is directly proportional to resistance, and heat is directly proportional to time of the circuit in which the current flows.
Moving on to applications of the heating effect of current. The heating effect of current is utilized in the working of electrical appliances such as electric iron, electric kettle, electric toaster, electric oven, room heaters, water heaters, geysers, etc. The heating effect of electric current is utilized even in electric bulbs or electric lamps for producing light. Tungsten metal is used for making the filaments of electric bulbs because it has a very high melting point, about of 3380 degrees Celsius. Bulb is filled with a chemically in unreactive gas like argon or nitrogen or a mixture of both. The heating effect of electric current is utilized in electric fuse for protecting household wiring and electrical appliances. A fuse is a short length of thin plated copper wire having low melting point. The fuse wire gets heated too much, melts and breaks the circuit, due to which the current stops flowing. When the current in a household's electric circuit rises too much due to some reasons such as overloading and short circuit. So these are the applications of the heating effect of current.
Moving on to the numericals based on Joule's law of heating effect. We have just derived Joule's law of heating effect, the derivation, and got a formula, that is heat is equals to I square RT, heat produced. So H is equals to I square RT. And based on this, there is a numerical here. A potential difference of 250 volts is applied across a resistance of 500 ohms in an electric iron. Calculate the current and heat energy produced in joules in 10 seconds. Okay, so let's write given first. The main concept of our understanding a sum is based on given. So the given is a potential difference of 250 volts V is equals to 250 volts is being given, is applied across a resistance of 500 ohms. So R is given, resistance 500 ohms. Okay, in an electric iron, calculate current, we have to calculate current, and heat energy produced in joules in 10 seconds. So time is given here, T is equals to 10 seconds. So in order to find, we have to write here to find, and we are going to calculate the current. I is equals to question mark and heat energy produced. Okay, second one is heat energy produced, H is equals to question mark. Now we have the formula for this. So we have already studied to find, that is to find the current. Let's write here formula. To find the current, we are using Ohm's law, I is equals to V by R. This is the formula what we are using, and we have got the Joule's law of heating effect, H is equals to I square RT. I square RT. These are the two formulas what we are using. Now moving on to the solution part. Let's all write here the solution. The first solution is we have to find the current. Okay, so we have the formula I is equals to V by R. So substituting the value of V, V is 250 volts and R is 500 ohms. So 250 ones are, 250 twos are 500. So I is equals to 1 by 2, which represents that is equals to 0.5, and the SI unit of current is amperes, 0.5 ampere. This is the current that we need to find. We have found the current. Now moving on to the second one. Okay, so we can take it as A, here we take it as B. Now B, heat energy produced, we have the formula H is equals to I square RT. This is the formula. So H, we have I square, that is 0.5 whole square into R resistance. Resistance we have 500 ohms into time. Time is 10 seconds. So H is equals to 0.5 whole square will be 0.25 into 500 into 10. Okay, 0.25 into 10 is 2.5, or we can also take it as 0.25 into 500. Okay, that is H is equals to 0.25 into 500 is 125, and into 10 H is equals to 1250. SI unit of heat, okay, is joules. So in results we are going to write the statement. In result, two statements must be written. The first statement is we have to write, calculate the current. Therefore the current is, okay, that is A, the current is we have got 0.5 ampere. Okay, and B, heat energy produced in joules. So heat energy produced is, heat energy produced is 1250 joules. So this is how we are going to solve the numerical. Now let's move on to the second numerical. Moving on to the next sum, which explains here, calculate the heat produced when 96,000 coulombs of charge is transferred in 1 hour through a potential difference of 50 volts. Okay, so let's write given here. We'll write the given things. First we'll write the given. In given we are having charge Q is equals to 96,000 coulombs. So it's in, it is in its SI unit itself, so need not worry. Transferred in 1 hour, time is equals to 1 hour. So 1 hour should be converted into seconds. We get that is equals to 60 seconds into 60 minutes into, so 60 minutes into 60 seconds is equals to 3600 seconds. Okay, that is 1 hour is equals to 3600 seconds. And the potential difference they have given, V is equals to 50 watts. And they have asked to calculate the heat produced. Okay, so to find now, before we need certain things. Now to find, they have told heat produced, and we have the formula H is equals to I square RT. Right, this is the heat produced formula. So now there we have I is not given, we have R there, R is also not given. So we need to find I, current and resistance. So first we'll write here I is equals to question mark, then we have to find R, resistance is equals to question mark, and finally we use that formula H is equals to question mark. We have to find the heat produced. Okay, so formulas, let's write the formula here. I'll write the formulas. The first one, I is equals to V by R. We have to calculate V by R. Now R is equals to V by I. This is the formula what we are using here. Okay. So, and H is equals to I square RT. So these are the formulas what we use here. Now let's move for the solution. Solution number one. Okay. I is equals to V by R. So we don't have V by R. So we can take here, we can take it as Q by T. I is equals to Q by T, because here Q is given and T is given. So I is equals to Q by T. So I is equals to Q by T, we can take it as. And Q is nothing but they are given 96,000 coulombs divided by time, that is 3600. If we cancel these two zeros, then we can cancel it. 960 divided by 36, we get, if we cancel, we can go on cancelling and we get it as 960 divided by 36. We get cancellation to 36, 2s are 32, 6.267. Yes. So 26.67 ampere. Okay, this is the current what we are getting here. If we calculate the current, now once we are getting the current, we are going for the resistance. Okay, so second solution, we have to find resistance. R is equals to V by I. So we have V. V is 50 divided by I. I is 26.67. Okay, so to remove the decimal into 100 by 100, we get 5000 by 2667. If you divide this 5000 by 2667, we get it as R is equals to 1.87 ohms. Okay, 1.87 ohms. Now this is what we have found. The resistance, we have found the current. Now we are going for the heat produced. This is the third solution. H is equals to I square RT. So let's write here, H is equals to I square. I square is 26.67 whole square, okay, into R. R we have got it as into 1.87, okay, and into t time is already we have calculated, that is 3600 seconds. So we can take H is equals to, that is heat produced is equals to 26.67 whole square. We get it as 711.2889. Okay, into 1.87, if we square it, please find the square by multiplying 26.67 into 26.67. 1.87 into 3600. Okay, so H is equals to, if we multiply 3600 into 1.87, okay, we get 6732. So we will write the same as it is, 711.2889 into 6 732. Multiplying these two. And totally if we multiply these both, that is 711.2889 into 6732, okay, we get approximately, this is the value, that is 478.8396.87 joules, okay. This is how much the heat is produced. So now this is in joules. We can also convert it in kilojoules by dividing it by 1000. So 1000 means the point jumps to 3 numbers towards the left. So we can write it as 4788.39 kilojoules. Okay, 39 can be rounded up to H is equals to 4788.4 kilojoules. So the heat produced, that is what the calculate the heat produced. So the heat produced in result, you are going to write that in result, you are going to write it. Heat produced is 4788.4 kilojoules. So here, this is what we end up this topic on Joule's law of heating effect. Okay, so these are the numericals. Please practice these numericals, and Joule's law of heating effect is also very important. Next class, we will be discussing about
electric power and commercial unit of electric power.
Still then, stay tuned to my channel, Gaurang the Motivator. Please subscribe, like, share, and comment. Thank you.